Again, I apologize for a set of ridiculous questions, but you mentioned cryptocurrencies and money. What is money? Why do we have money? Do you think about this kind of from this high philosophical level at times of this tool, this idea that we humans have all kind of came up with and seem to be using effectively to do stuff?
Money is a social construct, okay, in my opinion. And this has been somehow, people always felt that somehow money is a way to allow us to transact, even though we want different things. Yeah. So I have two sheep, and then you have one cow, and I want the cow, but you are looking for blankets instead, you know. So to have money, it really simplifies this. But at the end of, and that's why a bit was invented. And you started with gold, you started then with coinage, then you started with check. But at the end of the day, money is essentially a social construct, because you know that what you receive, you can actually spend with somebody else. And so there is a kind of a social pact and social belief that you have. At the end of the day, even a barter requires this beliefs that other people are going to accept the quote-unquote currency you offer them. Because if I'm a Mason and you ask me to build a wall in your field, and I did, and you, in exchange, you give me a thousand sheep, what am I going to do? Eat them all? No, I have to feed them. And if I don't feed them, they die, and my value is zero. So in receiving this livestock, I must believe that somebody else will accept them in return for something else.
Yeah,
so money is this social belief, social shared belief system that makes people transact.
That's fascinating. I didn't even think about that. That you're actually you have a deep like network of beliefs about how society operates. So the value is assigned even to sheep based on that everyone will continue operating how they were previously operating.
Yeah.
Somebody will feed the sheep. I didn't even think about that. That's fascinating. So that directly transfers to the space of money and then to the space of digital money, cryptocurrency. Okay. Does it bother you sort of intellectually when this money that is a social construct is not directly tied to physical goods like gold, for example?
Not at all, because after all, gold has some industrial value. Nobody denies it. It's a metal. It doesn't oxidate. It has some good things about it. But does this industrial value really represent the value at which it now is traded? No. So gold is another way to express our belief. I give you an ounce of gold, you treat it like, oh, somebody else will want this for doing something else. So it is really this notion of this. Money is a mental construct. It's really, and is shared, is a social construct, I believe. And so some people feel that it's physical, so therefore gold exists. Then, as you know now, countries, most sophisticated country right now, they print their own money, and you believe that they are not going to exaggerate it with inflation. Not everybody believes it, but I'm saying there is at least they are not going to exaggerate it blatantly, and therefore you receive it because you know that somebody else will accept it, will have faith in the currency, and so on and so forth. But whether it's gold, whether it's livestock, whatever it is, money is really a shared belief.